I'm going to be sharing the 5 self-care tips that actually helped me better and better in everything I do. I feel better and I'm leveling up in all areas of my life. Hello beautiful people, welcome back to my channel. If you're new to this channel, welcome. My name is Linda Eze. I'm a registered nurse. Remember to subscribe if this is the first time, and if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you don't like it, it's okay if you give it a thumbs down. Just say something about this video. Let's go. The first one is self-awareness. I cannot say much how this has actually helped me to level up in every area. Like, if I am aware of what is going on inside of me and outside of me, if I am aware of how I feel, how I'm dealing with people, how I'm reacting to situations, it will make me to actually think about what is going on, and it will make me to actually know how to move forward. So self-awareness, I am beginning to like take note of how I feel, how I react to situations, how I react to my children, how I react when things happen at work, and these are like indications of how I feel inside. If I'm able to like always ask myself these questions, like, how do you feel at this moment? Why are you snapping? Why are you shouting at this moment? Why are you feeling so stressed? Why are you not laughing a lot these days? These actually help you to come back to myself and actually examine where all these things are coming from. Because what you feel on the inside, what you say sometimes, is because of something that you are not even aware. Maybe you are too stressed. For me, I have realized that when I'm so stressed, maybe at work or when something is disturbing me a lot, then it reduces how often I smile. It reduces how often maybe I laugh and all those things. So if I don't laugh enough, if I don't smile, if I notice that I don't smile very often or the way I normally do, that means there is something, and then I'll have to sit down and I am look inside myself and know actually where these are coming from. And this brings me to the second one, which is journaling. So when I ask myself all these questions, why are you feeling this way now? What is actually going on? Why are you shouting at this person? Why are you snapping just because of something little that just happened? Then I journal. Journaling has helped me a lot to bring out all those things that are going on in my mind and put it down on paper. So if I see myself shouting, if I see myself not really laughing, I take my time to actually ask myself what is actually going on, and I put them down. Even if it doesn't happen only when I don't feel good, even when I feel good, even if I'm very happy, I still find time to just pick a pen and a paper, and then I write it down and say, well, today I'm so happy because this happened. Today I feel so stressed. Today I really don't feel like laughing a lot because this happened. And when I'm putting them down on paper, it relieves those stress, it relieves those anxiety and everything. And it also helps me to make notes of what I can do. I begin to think of what I can do to feel better, to do this one better, and to do that better. So journaling actually is one of the best things I have actually adopted that is really helping my life and helping everything that I do. So if you have not been journaling, try it and see if it's going to work for you. Another one is prioritizing myself. So as a mom, as a nurse, as a, we always learn all how to look after someone, to think of what's going on around you, to do this, to do that, to do that, and we forget to look after ourselves. For me, sometimes I even forget to eat. I'm running late, I'm looking after my child and something like that, and I forget to eat, I forget to make my hair, I forget to do this and do that. But I've learned that it's very good. If you don't look after yourself, then you are not even going to have enough strength to look after the people that actually matter to you, your kids, your husband, your whatever, you're at work as a nurse. If I am not healthy, then I'm not going to be able to do my best in my work. And as you know, as a nurse, you're not just giving medication and stuff. Everything about you is the nursing, how you react to patients, to what they do, how you approach patients, how you approach the patient relatives, your colleagues at work, and everything. So you have to be well in yourself and outside yourself for you to be able to do a good job. Self-care means different things to a lot of people. You will notice even on social media, some people, is when they look after themselves, maybe they'll go to the salon, they go to the spa. That is their own way of caring for themselves. But for me, I believe that it has to do with how we feel, both on the inside, on the outside, how we feel generally, and then how we look after ourselves mentally, physically, and otherwise. So I believe it's a wholesome thing. It doesn't just happen on the physical, it happens on the inside. And the best indication for me when I'm really when I feel like I've looked after myself is when I feel well, both inside of me and outside of me. I actually look in the mirror and I'm happy with what I see, and when I think about what's going on around me, how I feel is perfect. Okay, so another one I'm going to talk about today is reading. So I adopted reading a long time ago. I joined a reading club, a free reading club, when I was still in Nigeria, and they give me books to read free of charge. Some people think that, oh, because they don't want to like spend money on books. There are a lot of beautiful, wonderful organizations out there that are willing to give you books to read because they know how important it is to read. So they give people books and you read free of charge. The only thing that you need to do is to review the books, which I find very, very helpful, because when you read and then you put a note on what you've learned from that book, that is actually how you know or you remember most of the things that you read in that book. Don't just read them and then you drop them. So if you are someone that wants to adopt reading, a reading club is a way to go. And another one is meditating. I know a lot of things about meditating is going on in the social media these days, but the thing is, meditation actually means different things to different people. Sometimes if you decide, okay, I'm going to be meditating and I'm going to be dedicating every morning to meditation, which is very good, but I found that because of my schedule, because of family and everything, I'm not able to like make out that, okay, every morning or every night, because sometimes I'm on morning shift, sometimes I'm on evening shift, and then if I put it on my notes, oh, I'm going to be meditating every morning, and then I find myself going for night shifts or even day shift days and I don't have that time to meditate in the morning, then I feel very bad. Oh, I was supposed to be meditating. Oh, but I found that making out even 5 minutes to 10 minutes in the middle of the day, like during my break, my tea break, my lunch, my something, to just like close my eyes and think about if I'm so stressed, and just like catch my breath, take a deep breath, and actually remind myself that I am a human being, remind myself and be grateful for the work I'm doing, and be grateful that I still remember to meditate, and be grateful for everything that is going on around me, then it makes me to feel good, it makes me to feel better, it makes me to have that energy to continue whatever I'm doing. So meditating in between the days, in between activities, I found it to be extraordinarily very, very helpful. So if you're someone that really wants to adopt meditating, you can actually try meditating in the middle of the day if you are someone that is very busy. But if you can have a very good schedule where you meditate in the morning and meditate in the evening and you don't miss it, carry on, it's going to be very helpful. But for us that are very, very busy and don't have a particular schedule, consider meditating in between activities. I found it to be very, very helpful, and if you find it very helpful, please let me know in the comment below, and I'll be very good, very happy to see that it's also helpful to some people. But if it is not helpful as well, you can also share what you think in the comment below. There are so many other things that I actually do to help me. I exercise. As you can see, I exercise. I try to do press up and exercise and do some of those things that actually help me. But then these 5 things that I mentioned in this video, I find that these are actually the things that make me feel good physically, mentally. It helps me to stay on top of everything that I decide to do, and I know there are so many other things that will help you. Okay, so this is actually the first video in my self-care series, so if you have not subscribed, please subscribe and click the bell icon so that every time I post a new video, you'll be notified. Join the conversation, everybody. If you have anything that you want to share about self-care, drop them in the comment section and let us learn and level up together. I love you all, and I'll see you in the next video.